Welcome friends, the important quantities in the chemistry and their measurements. Let us have a look. As per the definition of the matter, which is consisting of two important things, one is mass and second one is volume. Whereas mass is measured in terms of grams as well as kgs, we are having two different systems for the measurement of all varieties of units. One is CGS system and second one is SI system. CGS system takes the help of the minor quantities, whereas in SI system we will take the help of the major quantities. Whereas per mass in CGS system the unit is grams, whereas in SI system the unit is kgs. Kg is greater compared to grams, whereas 1 kg is consisting of 1000 grams. And second one is volume. Volume in CGS system is measured in terms of cubic centimeters, that is centimeter cube. 1 centimeter cube is equal to 1 ml. Whereas the centimeter cube, the meaning is a cube made of all 1 centimeters length, width and height is having inside volume. That volume is said to be the 1 cubic centimeter. Similarly, in SI system, the unit used for the measurement of volume is meter cube. The meaning is a cube made up of 1 meter length, 1 meter width and 1 meter height, that is A is equal to B is equal to C is equal to 1 meter. Such a cube interior occupies that volume is said to be the 1 meter cube. Meter cube is greater than the centimeter cube. Whereas, as we know, 1 meter is consisting of 100 centimeters. 1 meter cube is equal to 100 centimeters whole cube. This will becomes equal to 10 power 6 centimeter cubes. Whereas centimeter cube is known as ml. This 10 power 6 can be written as 10 into, that is 1000 into 1000. 1000 centimeter cubes. 1000 ml is said to be the liter. Hence, it will becomes equal to 1000 liters. 1000 liters is said to be 1 meter cube. 1000 liters is known as 1 meter cube. Whereas this 1 meter cube is consisting of 1000 liters. Now we want to express 1 liter in terms of meter cubes. So therefore 1 liter will becomes equal to 1 by 1000 meter cubes. Whereas this can be written as 1 by 10 meter of whole cube. That is 1 by 10th of meter is said to be the decimeter. Hence it is decimeter cube. Thus 1 liter will becomes equal to 1 cubic decimeter, otherwise decimeter cube. Whereas deci stands for 1/10, centi stands for 1 by 100, whereas milli stands for 1 by 1000, micro stands for 1 by 10 power 6, nano stands for 1 by 10 power 9, and pico is very small, and that will becomes equal to 1 by 10 power 12. Volume, the three-dimensional space occupied by the matter objects is known as volume, whereas volume of solids and liquids are generally remains constant and they are not affected by the external conditions like temperature as well as pressure. But whereas the gases volume is highly influenced by the external conditions like temperature as well as the pressure, a small change in temperature offers a lot of change in the volume. A small change in pressure creates a lot of change in volume. So therefore, the volumes of the gases are influenced by the external conditions like temperature as well as the pressure. Whereas these are all influencing other quantities on volume are given in the form of an equation is said to be the ideal gas equation and is known as PV is equal to nRT. In this, V is our volume and except our volume, remaining things are P is pressure, N is number of moles, R is the constant, that is remains constant in the entire universe, which is equal to PV by NT, that is said to be the gases related constant, hence it is said to be the universal gas constant, and T is temperature. Let us move our discussion towards the quantities involved in the ideal gas equation, thus pressure. What is its CGS system of unit? What is its SI system of unit? What are its derived system of units? Similarly, number of moles we know, and the temperature followed by the R value and how it will be taken. These are all things. Let us have a discussion. Pressure, force acting per unit area is said to be the pressure, whereas the force F is given by F is equal to ma, whereas a is acceleration. That can be written in terms of mg also, because j is acceleration, once again acceleration due to gravity. Mg is said to be the weight of the substance. That is measured in two ways. In CGA system, the unit is grams, and in SI system, the unit is kgs. Whereas here I am having a surface area of 15 square centimeters. On that, suppose 15 grams of weight is present. That is, 15 grams of weight is present on 15 square centimeters. In this case, pressure, which is given by force per unit area, total force, that is weight, is equal to 15 grams, and that is present for the 15 square centimeters. Thus, pressure will be given by 15 grams by 15 square centimeters. That is one. That is one dyne per square centimeter. That is, CGA system of unit of pressure is dynes per square centimeter. Whereas SI unit of system is newton per meter square. Whereas newton per meter square is greater, because 1 newton per meter square consisting of 1 newton consisting of 10 power 5 dynes, whereas 1 meter square is consisting of 100 centimeter whole square, that will becomes equal to 10 power 5 by 10 power 4 is equal to 10 dyne per square centimeter. That is, 10 times of dyne per centimeter square will becomes equal to 1 newton per meter square. This newton per meter square is known as Pascal. Whereas 1 Pascal is equal to 10 dyne per centimeter square. Before going to the pressure, once again a deep discussion related to the force and its corresponding units. Force can be given by the push or the pull on an object with mass that can causes its change in its velocity is said to be the force. Whereas this force F is equal to ma, ma can be given by m is equal to a is equal to g, that is ma is equal to mg. Mg will nothing but what? Weight. Whereas it is having two varieties of measurements in CGS as well as the SI. In CGS system, dyne, whereas in SI system, newton. Newton is greater because it is a bigger unit compared to the dyne. 1 newton, generally indicated by capital N, will becomes equal to, in terms of the CGS system of units of MEA units, 1 kg, and here meter per second square, whereas that in terms of grams, 1000 grams, whereas meter in centimeters will becomes equal to 100 centimeters per second square, which will becomes equal to 10 power 3 plus 10 power into 10 power 2, that is 10 power 5 grams centimeter per second square, whereas that will becomes equal to 10 power 5. This particular unit in CGS system of the pressure, which is said to be the dyne, thus 1 newton will becomes equal to 10 power 5 dynes. The pressure units in case of CGS as well as the SI systems. In case of CGS system, that will becomes equal to dyne per centimeter square, whereas in SI system, that is newton per meter square. Newton per meter square is greater, whereas newton per meter square will becomes equal to newton in terms of dynes. 1 newton is equal to 10 power 5 dynes, and 1 meter is equal to 100 centimeter. 1 meter square will becomes equal to 100 centimeter whole square, hence it is 10 power 5 by 10 power 4 dyne per centimeter square. Whereas this is the CGS system of unit of the pressure, 10 power 5 by 10 power 4 will becomes equal to 10. So therefore, 10 dyne per centimeter square, 1 newton per meter square, which will becomes equal to 1 Pascal. This 1 Pascal will becomes equal to 10 dynes per centimeter square. So therefore, 1 Pascal, which is equal to 1 newton per meter square, is equal to 10 dyne per centimeter square. Thus, in vice versa, 1 dyne per centimeter square is equal to 1 by 10 Pascals, which is equal to 0.1 Pascals, that is 0.1 Newton per meter squares. Atmospheric pressure and its calculation. Whereas atmosphere is collection of the gases, these gas molecules are also having some weight. Up to some kilometers together, the gas is present in the atmosphere. Due to these particular gases molecules, they will offer some weight for the unit area. That weight offered by the atmospheric gases per unit area is said to be the its corresponding pressure. For its calculation, we will take a glass vessel filled with the mercury, because it is having higher density. and in this an evacuated gas vessel is kept, whereas that is having uniform cross section area. Due to this atmospheric gases force, that weight, here the mercury molecule enters into the evacuated vessel, their level increases and reaches to certain level and it becomes saturated. The bottom to the high level height difference is taken as height, whereas within this unit area this particular weight is offered by the atmospheric gases, and if we calculate this particular weight, then that will becomes equal to force. So therefore pressure is given by force for unit area, whereas force will becomes equal to here weight for unit area. Weight will becomes equal to mass into gravity, whereas that mass will becomes equal to volume into density, whereas volume will becomes equal to area into height, and remaining all things, density into gravity divided by area remains same. Area gets cancelled. Now it becomes equal to unit area. Denominator becomes 1 implies what? Unit area. On unit area, whatever the weight offered, this weight offered will becomes equal to multiplication product of height raised in the mercury column, density of the mercury liquid taken, and g is acceleration due to gravity. H into d into g will becomes equal to the pressure offered by the atmosphere, hence it is said to be the atmospheric pressure. Whereas from the experimental informations of the height raised in the mercury column, atmosphere related pressure is calculated, that will becomes equal to H into D into G. That now I am calculating in terms of dynes per centimeter square, whereas here the height raised is up to 76 centimeters difference, whereas density of the mercury is 13.6 gram per ml. Acceleration due to gravity in terms of CGS system is 980.6 centimeter per second square. Altogether multiplication, it is found to be 1013250 dyne per centimeter square. Whereas this can be written as 10 times of 1013250, because 10 dyne per centimeter square will becomes equal to 1 newton per meter square. It is also known as Pascal, hence it will becomes equal to 1013250 Pascals. Thus I can write it one as 1.01325 into 10 power 5 Pascals. Thus one atmospheric pressure is very high compared to the systematic units like dynes per centimeter square, it is very huge, whereas in newton per meter square also it is present in 10 power 5 multiples. So therefore the CGS and the SI system related units are not works properly, because the regular atmospheric pressure is 10 power 5 times greater. Hence we have to go for the new units for the measurement, and those two new units are, one is bar and second one is the atmosphere. So the bigger units are taken for easiness of convenience, and those of all are non-systematic units and are said to be the derived units. Those derived units are two, one is bar and second one is atmosphere, whereas one bar is equal to 10 power 5 Pascals, whereas one atmosphere is equal to 1.01325 into 10 power 5 Pascals. Now the Pascal and the bar interrelation, see here Pascal as well as bar are interrelated in such a way that one atmosphere is equal to 1 by 1.01325 bars, that will becomes equal to 0.987 bars. So one atmosphere is equal to 1 by 1.01325 bars, whereas that will becomes equal to 0.987. So therefore one bar is equal to atmospheres, that will becomes equal to 0.987 atmospheres will becomes equal to 1 bar. Thus the pressure units, systematic as well as the derived units, if we talk about CGS as well as the SI systematic units, and the bar and atmospheres are the derived systematic units. This is dyne per centimeter square, it is newton per meter square, which is known as Pascal, and here it is bars and it is atmospheres. Whereas in terms of the Pascals, if I express the bars and the atmospheres, it is so huge. 10 power 5 Pascals is equal to 1 bar, that is 1.01325 into 10 power 5 pascals, 10 power 5 newton per meter square will becomes equal to 1 atmosphere. Whereas the bigger quantity is atmosphere, smaller quantity is dyne per centimeter square. Compared to dyne per centimeter square, newton per meter square is greater. Compared to newton per meter square, pascal is greater. Compared to pascal, atmosphere is greater. Whereas if I take 1 atmosphere, more than 1 times of bars are present, that is 1.01325 bars. Whereas this one will becomes equal to 1.01325 into 10 power 5 newton per meter square. Whereas this will becomes equal to 10 into 1.01325 into 10 power 5, think about what, 10 power 6, 9 per centimeter square. In that way, these units are interrelated with one another. Temperature. Temperature is measured in three different ways. One is absolute scale, that is also said to be the Kelvin scale. Second one is degree centigrade scale, known as Celsius scale. And third one is Fahrenheit scale or degree Fahrenheit scale. Whereas in between the absolute scale as well as the degree centigrade scale, the relation is every Kelvin will become equal to corresponding degree centigrade plus 273. Whereas suppose if it is 0 degree centigrade, 0 followed by 273, it will become equal to 273 Kelvins. If it is 100 degree centigrade, 100 plus 273, it will become equal to 373. Whereas the SI unit of temperature is Kelvin. Whereas the degree centigrade as well as the Fahrenheit relation, degree Fahrenheit will become equal to 9 by 5 times of degree centigrade plus 32. Suppose if it is 0, 0 followed by something 0 plus 32, 32 Fahrenheit. Whereas if it is 100, 9 by 5 into 100, 20 into 9, 180, 180 plus 32, it will become equal to 212 degree Fahrenheit. From ideal gas equation, PV is equal to nRT, R is universal gas constant which will become equal to PV by NT. Whereas the units of R we are discussing, PV by NT. Whereas the pressure in atmospheres, volume in liters, that is liter atmosphere per mole Kelvin, per mole per Kelvin. Whereas this pressure is force per unit area, whereas volume is area into one particular dimension of length, that is centimeters, by mole Kelvin. If you take this area, both can getting cancelled, that is force into displacement, force into length, nothing but what, work. Work is one form of energy. Thus you are having units in terms of work for mole Kelvin, otherwise energy for mole for Kelvin. Whereas this energy can be present in terms of CJS system, that is ergs per mole for Kelvin, SI system, joules per mole for Kelvin, and the smaller units are there at the same time. Bigger units are there in smaller units, electron volts per mole Kelvin, whereas in the bigger units, calories per mole Kelvin. These are the different varieties of standard units taken for the R. Now we will write the values of R in different units. On substituting the corresponding values in the ideal gas equation, the values of R, universal gas constant, which is always constant, but with the different units of representation, its value changes. These are equal to one another. Thus, R is equal to all these things. That is equal to 0.0821 liter atmosphere per mole Kelvin, whereas 8.314 joules per mole per Kelvin, whereas 8.314 into 10 power 7 ergs per mole Kelvin, 1.987 calories per mole per Kelvin, which is also equal to 5.198 into 10 power 19 electron volts per mole per Kelvin. And another unit regularly or oftenly used is bar liter per mole Kelvin, which is equal to 0.08314 bar liter per mole per Kelvin. Question is, calculate the volume occupied by the nitrogen gas of 3.5 grams under STP conditions. Here STP conditions stands for standard temperature, that is temperature is 273 Kelvin and the pressure is 1 atmosphere. Under those atmospheres, Kelvins as well as liters related conditions of corresponding R value is 0.0821 liter atmosphere per mole per Kelvin. So PV is equal to nRT, whereas value is given by nRT by P, that is weight by gram molecular weight, number of moles. R is 0.0821, temperature is 273, pressure is 1. Altogether it becomes equal to 2.8 liters. Question is, calculate the volume occupied by a gaseous mixture of 2 grams of hydrogen and 2 grams of helium under STP conditions. Another condition is similar to that of STP. Another one, temperature conditions and the standard condition is NTP. Otherwise, another one usual condition is NTP. The meaning of NTP is normal temperature and pressure. Whereas under normal temperature and pressure, pressure remains same. Whereas temperature is normal temperature 27 degree centigrade, which is 27 plus 273, which is equal to 300 Kelvin. Under these conditions, the volume occupied by 1 molar gas is gram molar volume, that is molar volume under NTP conditions, that can be given by PV is equal to nRT, V is equal to nRT by P. Here molar value implies what? Number of moles are 1. So 1 into RT by P, 1, R is equal to 0.0821, temperature is equal to 300, whereas pressure is equal to 1. Altogether it becomes equal to 24.63. Generally we can say it as 24.6 liters. Thus, 1 molar substance of any gas under NTP conditions occupies a volume of 24.6, whereas under STP conditions it is 22.4, NTP conditions it is 24.6. Yes, under STP conditions it is 22.4 and under NTP conditions it is 24.6. In a cylinder under STP conditions of total volume of 19.6 liters, out of that 11.2 liters of volume is occupied by carbon dioxide, 5.6 liters of volume is occupied by oxygen, 2.8 liters of volume is occupied by helium. Then you are asked to calculate the total weight of gas mixture present in the cylinder. Question is, once again, under STP conditions, in a cylinder of total 19.6 liters, 11.2 liters of volume is occupied by carbon dioxide, 5.6 liters of volume is occupied by oxygen, and 2.8 liters of volume is occupied by helium. Then you are asked to calculate total weight of gas mixture present in the cylinder. Another question is, under a certain temperature and pressure conditions, 1 gram of helium occupies a volume of 8.4 liters. Then, if this is so, then calculate the volume occupied by carbon monoxide gas of 14 grams under the valid given temperature and the pressure conditions. A table related to the number of moles and the corresponding standard conditions related value. Suppose number of moles are 1, volume occupied is 22.4 liters under STP conditions. Under the same STP conditions, if it is half mole, 0.5 moles, then the volume occupied is half of this one, that is 11.2 liters. If it is 1/3 mole, the corresponding volume occupied is 7.46 liters. If it is 1/4 mole, the corresponding volume occupied is 5.6 liters. If it is 1/8 of mole, that is 2.8 liters. If it is 1/16 of mole, then that will become equal to what? 1.4 liters. If the substance taken is helium, so therefore 1 mole stands for 4 grams of helium, 4 grams of helium 1 mole, which is equal to 22.4 liters under STP conditions. Similarly, 2 grams of helium, that is half mole, 0.5 moles, 1 by 2 moles, which will occupy a volume of 11.2 liters under steepy conditions. If it is 1/3 mole implies 1.33 grams, which is 0.33 moles, which will occupy a volume of 7.46 under given steepy conditions. If it is 1 gram, that will be 1/4 mole, 0.25 moles, corresponding volume is 5.6 liters under given steepy conditions. If it is 0.5 grams, that is 1/8 mole, 1/8 implies 0.125 moles, that will occupy a volume of 2.8 liters under given steepy conditions. If it is 0.25 grams, that is 1/16 mole, 1/16 stands for half of 1/8, 1/8 how much you got, this is 0.125, so this is 0.0625 moles, which will occupy a volume of 1.6 liters under given STP conditions. See here once again clearly, 1 gram which is equal to 4 grams which is equal to 1 mole, 1 mole occupies a volume of 22.4 liters under STP. Whereas 2 grams, that is half mole, which is equal to 0.5 moles, occupies a volume of 11.2 liters. That is 1.33 grams, that is 1/3 mole, number of moles are 0.33. Total volume is 7.46 liters under STP conditions. If it is 1 gram, 1/4 mole, that is 0.25 moles, which is equal to 5.6 liters under STP conditions. And here 0.05 grams, that is 1/8 mole, which is equal to 0.125 moles, that is occupying a volume of 2.8 liters under STP conditions. If it is 0.25 grams of helium, the total number of moles are weight upon gram molecular weight 1/16, which is equal to 0.0625 moles, occupies a volume of 1.6 liters under given STP conditions.